Welcome to That's Good Broncos podcast number one. I'm Brandon Perna with Ryan fucking Greene of Green Belt Industries, CEO and executive. CEO and executive.
I actually grew up on a Green Belt.
Right.
So that's actually impressive that you knew that.
Yeah, Ryan's company focuses on making sure green initiatives never happen.
Okay. The minute they have as much money as oil companies, then, you know, then I'll listen, but they just don't.
Where the fuck are the Bears? Did I pass them?
There they are.
Okay. So what Ryan and I are going to do is we're going to talk about the Broncos. We're going to preview the Broncos' first preseason game between Denver and Chicago. I'm going to play a Chicago because I am willing to bet that Ryan is much better at this game than me.
I will bet that too.
So we're going to predict who's going to win based on this, and we're going to update you on everything you need to know about the Denver Broncos, including this phone call I'm about to take.
Ooh.
Hello? Hello?
By one or more of your vendor.
If only your phone had a speaker option.
Or possibly all of your debt eliminated due to a violation of the Fair Credit Reporting Act.
Ooh, I can get all of my debt eliminated.
yeah, right.
Right. Hey, why did my team change?
Oh my gosh.
Oh, I can't go back up.
That's why. Do that.
I gotta do this right.
Use the D-pad.
Where the fuck?
What universe are you in? No wonder it wasn't in order.
Well,
keep going. There you go. Now you got it.
All right. Off to a shaky start here.
Yeah, Brandon has to learn how to use a PlayStation first.
Yeah, I'm an Xbox man. We're on PS4.
Well, yeah, right now I'm the home team. I don't know if you care.
Yep. Yep, I care.
Well, like, we're gonna have to switch.
Do we have to switch sides?
Yeah.
Oh.
If to use the
defense. Okay. Yes, because this game will be in Chicago.
Yeah.
We are playing Madden 16, but Ryan has updated the roster, so...
Yeah, so user-created players. So I have Paxton Lynch on my team, I have Devontae Booker, all that stuff.
Yeah, you got to start with Sanchez, though. That's the rule.
I will start with Sanchez, I promise.
Okay, so Ryan and I have been at the Broncos training camp. Well, Brian's been there every day. I've been there like 4 or 5 days so far, so... We are up to speed on everything that's happening. Do I gotta push something?
Yeah, hit X. There you go.
Okay.
I would set yours to all pro, because pro, yeah, there you go.
All right.
You're good. All right.
So there's a lot that's happened since training camp started, and this first game, most notably recently, the Broncos have named Mark Sanchez the... Brian's pushing all my buttons for me. Because I don't know what the fuck
Not
I'm doing.
Not the way you think.
They named Sanchez the starter. Yeah, could do 5-minute quarters. Yeah. We don't want six. That means nothing right now. He's going to get a quarter. Simeon's going to get a quarter. And then Lynch is going to get the second half. It's still an open competition, supposedly, between those guys. But from everything Ryan and I have seen at practice, neither one of them looks like a dominant quarterback.
Yep.
This game, I honestly think... We'll tell a lot about him, but I could be wrong. And in terms of preseason games, this is the most excited I've been about a preseason game for a while.
Yeah, I still have this crippling fear that once Siemian actually plays game speed, it's going to go downhill for him. I don't know why. He just seems like that kind of person. I want to like him. I don't know. He hasn't convinced me to like him.
Right. Well, neither one. I mean, here's the thing. Everybody's talking about this quarterback battle every day. But to be honest, the stuff you see them do at practice doesn't tell you shit right now.
No.
Like they...
Especially when the pads are off.
Like, yeah, and most days the pads are off.
Mm-hmm.
And even the days they're not, they're in shoulder pads and they're kind of just doing half sort of contact. I don't even know if I've seen a full contact practice yet. I know they've had them. I'm just not sure if I was there those days.
Yeah, they've had full pads, but yeah, they certainly haven't like tried to hit each other.
So this game in Chicago is going to be very telling. Is our point?
Oh yeah.
I'm
going to make sure Sanchez is starting.
I asked you guys on Twitter to tell me which questions we should discuss. So I'm going to go through those. Some guy says he needs to know about the long snapper. What's his name, Ryan? Do you remember the long snapper's name?
It's number 42.
It is 42.
Let's see if he's on the roster.
I've stood by 42 quite a bit. Here's what you need to know. He will be the long snapper. And so far, all
there
of his...
There is no long snapper competition.
There's all the long snaps have been made. somebody says, are That's Good Broncos still going to be a thing even though you're a big shot now?
When did you become a big shot?
Still haven't become a big shot. Oh, you have a very loose definition of what the word fucking big shot means. But I appreciate it, True Panda, for thinking of me as being better than I really am. And it should be is That's Good Broncos, not are That's Good Broncos.
Yeah, bro.
It's just me. Which Bronco would make the best boyfriend and treat you right? Now, this is a very good question. We can start the game.
Did it really end with treat you right?
Yeah, they want to know who would treat you right.
Wow.
You know, to be honest, after being at camp and you get to hear the players talk or you're standing close enough to see them, to see the sweat glisten off of their bodies, a lot of them seem like really nice guys. I think a lot of them would treat you right.
I agree. I think Emmanuel Sanders is the most attractive player.
Ooh, I disagree. It's DeMarcus Ware.
I see that.
Nobody's better looking than D. Ware. D. Ware's got like movie star looks.
His body though.
Sanders seems like the coolest player on the team. Like if you're gonna date a player and you want to like do cool stuff and be cool all the time, then you do Sanders.
Do Sanders hard.
Oh man, it doesn't tell me the routes.
Uh-oh,
this is going to be tricky.
I mean, I would know.
Jay Cutler completing his first pass to Alshon Jeffrey.
There you go. you miss Jay Cutler?
No.
You don't?
You know, when Jay Cutler was first traded, I was like, this is stupid. And it probably was stupid. He's a better quarterback than Kyle Orton. There's no doubt about that.
Yeah.
But... You know, if we kept Cutler, I don't think we would have ended up with Peyton Manning.
I will completely agree with that.
I mean, does Josh McDaniels draft Tim Tebow if him and Cutler get along? It's a whole Pandora's box you open there, Ryan.
I'm sorry.
But then, you know, after you see what Cutler's done in Chicago and how everybody kind of hates him, it's nice not to have the most hated quarterback on the team. I guess we had to deal with that anyway with Tim Tebow. Very polarizing QB.
Yeah, I certainly hated him. I won't shy away from that.
That was the first defensive play you made, by the way.
Oh!
Not looking good for the Broncos right now.
Well, you know, if you listen to ESPN, the Broncos had their defense decimated. it's going to be a long year.
Yeah, you know? They lost two starters. They lost two important reserves, though, in Bruton and Bolden. And you could technically, I would call David Bruton a starter.
Yeah, but boy, does Justin Simmons look good. Oh. Get the hell out of here.
Oh, he caught it!
Oh.
Alshon Jeffrey. Now, the reason, again, I'm playing as the Bears is because I'm shittier than Ryan, and I wanted the Broncos to win. But if I beat him, this is going to look really bad for my channel.
Boy, that was more embarrassing for Tlaib than the gunshot, that catch.
Ooh.
That was too soon?
No, it's not too soon.
All right.
I mean, that's super embarrassing.
So who are you watching Thursday?
Thursday night's game, obviously, you know, we're going to watch Sanchez and Siemian closely. And I guess Lynch in that second half or whatever. But offensive line, which is like, I mean, Ty Sambrailo's out with that. He's got a dislocated elbow. Russel Okung isn't playing. So we're not even going to get a fair look at that. I think Schofield starting at left tackle, that'll be interesting to watch. He's going to end up.
Just cringed.
Yeah, he's going to end up as guard this season. But this game, he's at tackle. I don't know. It'll be interesting to see how that unit performs. I don't even know how long they'll all be on the field. The reserve safeties will be... They'll be good to look at. You're talking Justin Simmons. Will Parks is going to play. Shiloh Kato will be out there. Because David Bruton was a huge part of the success in that secondary last season. And it sucks because he said he was healthy enough to play in the Super Bowl, but they had already put him on the
yeah. And he was such a good guy, too. Like, I don't know what Denver Bronco fan didn't...
Oh.
Is that a... Get out of here. Oh, Chris Harris ain't letting him at... Come on. That's a rookie. This isn't happening.
How am I owning you right
this
now?
This is Madden. That's... It's maddening. Well... No, anyways, back to David Bruton. I mean, he's just such a good guy. I was really upset when he left. Because just the presence he brought, I think he was the Broncos Man of the Year recipient for the team. The Walter Payton Award.
Right.
So, yeah, and he was a big part of the community. So it's just, but trust me, Justin Simmons is the real deal.
Yeah. He's a big guy. What's he like, 6'2", 6'1"?
I believe so, yeah.
He, standing next to like the other defensive backs, he's definitely like, he's the tallest. Because I like to, during practice, shoot video over by the defensive backs because they make me feel the most like a normal sized person.
And they're the closest you can get to them.
Yeah, they practice right by the sideline. And they're all like, you know, 5'10 to 6 foot. And even though I'm still a lot shorter than that, I feel like, hey, I could probably go out there and play football if I needed to. I'm not standing next to Derek Wolfe, so.
Yeah, you should meet Wes Welker.
Yeah, exactly. they like Simmons. Lorenzo Doss should have a bigger role.
He's had a great camp. He's one of the players that continuously like stands out during practice,
right.
For me at least. He makes plays.
And he should, I mean, if Talib gets suspended, he's going to be that third corner, right?
He's got a split time with at least Kayvon.
Kayvon, yeah, that's right. Kayvon Webster, Lorenzo Doss, who you want to, I guess we'll look at, because Talib's not playing.
Right.
So we'll see Harris and Roby for a little bit. And
yeah, watch them make the Talib announcement as we're recording this.
Right. So the word on the street is the NFL is saying nothing less than an 8-game suspension for Aqib Talib, which is fucking ridiculous.
Talk about shooting yourself in the foot.
Right. I don't know. I guess I feel like it's karma almost for how badly I've wished for Tom Brady to be suspended. and it seems like the world's just punishing me with if Talib gets suspended for that long.
Ugh,
I don't think you can suspend him, though, until like the legal process is finished. He hasn't been convicted of anything.
Right.
I mean, if he didn't...
I don't know.
If they can't put him in the club with the gun, then he did nothing illegal.
Yeah, I don't know what Texas state laws are, but I just don't know what you could do.
And let's say you can't prove that he shot himself. That means somebody else shot him and you're going to suspend him?
Yeah.
That can't be good.
Ooh, oh, all right. I think you're a little better than I thought you were.
I'm not very good at this video game, Ryan. I just know football so well that my instincts kick in, and...
You've been reading your YouTube comments too much.
I just play ball.
All right.
I just play ball.
I forgot you're a big shot now, so...
Yeah, that guy said I was a big shot. Ah, this... I can't remember... Oh, okay. One bad throw. I'm really rooting for you to win, too. That's what's weird. Like, the competitor in me... isn't going to let you win the game, but I want you to win because I can't beat the Broncos on Madden.
For any superstitious fan out there, every Super Bowl win for the Broncos has started with a Week 1 preseason win.
Ooh.
That's a good stat. Golden gossip right there.
That is a good stat.
And I think it goes, I couldn't remember what years they went in the 80s, but it went back to like 77, they won the first preseason game.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so...
So this is an important game.
Yeah.
And we're playing against, you know, former head coach John Fox, who's got to be pissed. Like, Broncos let him go, and then he gets to watch his two former teams playing the Super Bowl.
Well, be pissed all you want. It's not like Elway cleaned out his team. It was basically the same roster. If anyone should feel bad, it's Jack Del Rio.
Yeah.
For not...
Oh, my God. not looking good for the Broncos on Thursday night.
I guess man defense is not good.
Oh, Jeffrey just took a selfie, too.
Oh!
if there were a cell phone there, that would have been a penalty.
It probably would be a penalty. I'm amazed Madden let that happen.
I think it helps me not seeing the routes. I just play by.
I think I need to go zone. You've been working zone and you did it pretty well. So I've been doing too much man. Sorry, I play like the Broncos.
Oh yeah, I gotta kick it. It's kind of hard to play Madden and talk so much. I'm gonna say that right now.
Yeah. Normally I'm just cussing at the screen.
Yeah.
Because it's never my fault.
Normally I'm like, happens. This game's taking 40 minutes of my time. Jesus, I could have done something productive.
I'm an adult. You have a fiance, like it's...
I know. I got like adult things happening now. Fiance, we're getting a house, we're getting married in 2 weeks.
I'm
very stressed. Not about the wedding. I'm very sure about my decision I'm making.
How sure are you of her decision that she's making?
Oh, we're 100%. We are on the same page. It's like,
it's very bold of you.
You know, it's a good relationship, Ryan.
Okay. I haven't met her yet.
I know. When you meet the perfect person for you, you know. She laughs at most everything I say. She says a lot of really funny stuff, too. And she doesn't give me shit about not having a real job, you know? I can talk about the Broncos and try to chase the YouTube dream, and she supports me 100%.
So when you go home tonight and she asks, what did you do today?
Be like, I recorded a very important Madden podcast.
And you kicked Ryan's ass as the Bears.
I kicked Ryan's ass at the Bears, which totally backfired.
That was it.
Ooh, you should have Siemian in now. It's the second quarter.
Oh, it is the second quarter. All right, after this play, I'll put him in.
Ooh, CJ missing the pass. Yeah,
actually, that was a very Sanchez throw. I've seen him make those kind of throws.
Yeah.
Hell's Angels sponsoring this break.
That's just a motorcycle. We are in the heart of Denver. A very cool studio space set up by the Lombardi brothers.
Adelio
and Vic.
Victorio.
Big shout out if they listen to this, which they won't.
Yeah, they got shit to do.
If you guys listen to this, tweet Ryan and I and say, good work, guys. You're doing a swell job.
And don't tweet anything other than that.
Yeah. I'm going to get back on those Twitter questions.
Okay.
Let's see here. Punting situation has me on pins and needles. Who replaces Talib if suspended? Webster, Doss, or other? From Greg Breslau.
I think week one, you're going to see Kayvon and Roby on the outside and Harris playing slot.
He was asking about... Oh, okay, yeah, the corners.
I think Lorenzo Doss makes the team, makes the active roster. He didn't make a lot of active rosters last year.
I'll agree with that. If Talib's suspended, Webster will probably come in. But I think Doss has more potential to be a better coverage guy than Webster. Webster plays physical. It's kind of like a hybrid safety corner.
Yeah.
I think Colquitt's going to make the team. I know the Broncos probably want to clear up his salary, but just based on watching him and Dixon punt at practice, Colquitt's much more consistent. He doesn't have, like, Dixon will punt some bad balls. Colquitt's are usually pretty good. Except when they got out there in the team drills the other day, Colquitt kind of shanked his first two. Dixon has a bigger leg, and he has that athletic skill set to be a threat as a punt fake runner, as you've all seen when he was drafted.
Oh, that's right. I always forget about that highlight.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
He's hurtling dudes.
I might have to ask him about that stuff.
I think returning kicks, I think a guy to watch out for, and a lot of people have talked about him, but he continues to impress, is Khalif Raymond.
He is quick.
Him and Norwood will be battling to be that kind of slot receiver, but Khalif could solve the Broncos' problems as a punt returner.
Mm-hmm.
That's a big position up for grabs still. They haven't had a good punt returner since they had to let go of Trendon Holiday because he couldn't catch footballs.
I kind of miss Trendon Holiday.
Yeah.
It was
Holiday Road.
It was a heart attack every time he attempted to catch it, but...
He was electric.
He was, seriously, especially, I know we lost the Ravens playoff game, but without him, we might have lost by 2 touchdowns.
Exactly. Oh, that game.
He's not even in the league anymore, is he?
I don't think so, because he played for the Giants after that. Ooh. Under pressure, you get it off. The DT.
Yeah.
Who is a monster.
He looks back to normal, man.
That guy is so big. You know he's big, and then you see him, and he towers over people.
You see him and you go, how did he run a 4.340?
Right.
Simeon's 3 for 3. Look at this.
Oh, Siemian working the hurry up.
I seriously don't even know what plays they are. I can't see it. They won't let me.
There we go. I'm Danny Trevathan. He's going to sack you.
Hey.
Oh, yeah. Out of bounds for DT.
No way. No, that's a catch. That's a first and 10.
No, I meant you stop the clock.
Oh, okay, good.
Of supporting you.
Oh, no, wait, he didn't stop the clock.
Oh, you're...
Oh, fatigue's on? Oh, jeez.
What is fatigue?
Where the players, like, get tired and fumble more. And...
That's stupid.
It's stupid because Madden has them get tired after 2 plays. These are professional athletes. They're not going to be... It's garbage.
I think that's why this game annoys me. It's like, they've done a good job of trying to make it super realistic. But honestly, like, I'd rather play Blitz.
Oh, Blitz was so... Why did we not do a Blitz podcast? Oh.
We can. This is all just right, the first one.
All right.
Do they have Blitz for Xbox and PS4?
They made them into... I knew they made... I think they stopped making it for PlayStation 3. I think that was like Xbox 360, PlayStation 3.
There might be like downloads, like...
Maybe. I may just have to dig up my N64.
Oh, man. Oh, that'd be cool.
Okay, well, the offensive line in Madden is as garbage as it was last year.
So far, we also noticed that Madden has the Bears' defense as being very dominant.
Actually, the Bears' defense is, I think a lot of people are sleeping on it. I don't think they're going to be as terrible as they were.
No, they were bad last year, but they added pieces.
Yeah.
Although they cut Omar Bolden. He didn't sign anywhere, did he?
No, I thought he's got to be close to retirement. I heard, I heard.
Is he hurt? Injury issues?
It's the knee. I heard some people at Broncos training camp talking about him, some higher ups, and they think his knee is just shot, which is too bad.
Yeah, that sucks. He was at TJ Ward's golf tournament.
He was a nice guy.
Yeah, he's a really nice guy. Preseason, he got lit up against the 49ers last year. He had to leave the game, I think maybe with a concussion.
Wasn't that because Anquan
It was a bad hit.
Yeah.
It was a dirty hit that didn't get called.
Yeah. Anquan Bolden's a little bitch.
I'm not sure he ever recovered from that.
He had the awesome punt return against the Colts.
Yeah, that was the thing. He started him. He had that punt return against the Colts that sort of gave the Broncos hope. Until the defense fell apart in that fourth quarter last year with the eye gouge and the penalties. They did almost kill Andrew Luck, though. Oh, fuck. I don't even know what play it
That's
is.
True.
Oh, I'm trying to
Ooh,
help you.
Ooh, Chris Harris.
Triple coverage.
Take it and run, dude.
You got to make that pick.
At least he does a no-fly zone animation. That's good. Yeah. My Parks and Rec thing isn't taking off either. I've tried.
Trying to get him to do it?
People are just laughing at me.
Yeah, Ryan wants Will Parks. And you want Simmons to go as Rec?
Yeah, just that's his nickname, Rec.
So that we can call him Parks and Rec. And Ryan will be Amy Poehler.
Yeah, I can do that. It's just, but they're just going to become a part of the no-fly zone, so it's a lost cause at this point.
We'll make it a thing.
Okay.
That's good Broncos will make it a thing. They both have to get significant time, though.
That's true. I don't know how much Parks will get it, but they have been putting Simmons in with the ones. They've been dropping TJ Ward in as like a linebacker. So it gets...
Oh!
Chris Harris!
How do you not pick that?
What are you doing? There's 9 seconds left.
Ryan, you got to hit triangle. You got to hit the button that helps him catch.
I'm trusting the game too much.
Got to do the button that helps him catch, dude. Oh, punting it away. Playing it safe.
9 seconds left, you better.
Oh, you son of a bitch.
Look at you. That's what you get.
I honestly had no idea what play I called there. I thought I was running an offensive play. All right, I'm giving you, I gave you 6 seconds to get this, turn this into a game.
All right. Don't put that on me.
If I win and then the Broncos lose and they don't win the Super Bowl, it's all going to come back to this moment. We are basically setting up the rest of the season, Ryan.
All right.
I play as Trevathan Omen.
Okay.
I'm going to pick you.
Yeah, I bet you are.
Oh,
DT, come on. All right, 1 second left.
You got one come more on, buddy. Chance. One more chance.
The other cool thing to see is there are a lot of former Broncos on the Bears.
Yeah.
They're the Broncos of the Midwest.
Yeah, they got Danny Trevathan. Is Mitch Unrein still there?
I think he is. You should put him in at halftime. Ha! Like I would run it.
Oh, no, no.
Benny Fowler, catch it!
By the way, Benny Fowler, he catches most everything at practice.
He's surprised me.
Him and Latimer both looked really good.
Boy, I don't know about Cody. I don't know.
He's got, what, a hammy? Does his hammy hurt? They were stretching him out the other day.
Yeah, He's looked good in practice, but really think it's because the coaches are telling the quarterbacks to throw it to him to see if he's...
Well, that's kind of been his MO for the last two seasons, is he's looked really good in training camp, and then when he got on the field, it didn't translate. But part of that could be him and Manning didn't really have chemistry, and some people think that, you know, Manning's so cerebral and he demands so much from his receivers that the pressure for that wasn't good for Latimer. I don't know what of that is true, but maybe with a different quarterback, his production increases. But
I got to put Paxton in.
I mean, if you look at him and you look at Demaryius Thomas and Benny Fowler, like those are three big receivers who
can bail Sanchez out.
Right. It would be kind of crazy to have all three of those guys on the field at the same time. I mean, even though you probably wouldn't, because they're going to mostly be at a two-receiver set, sometimes three, and Sanders is going to be in that mix, which you want anyway. But three big guys.
I have heard people at Broncos camp explain that Cody Latimer isn't necessarily mentally quick at football smarts.
Gotcha.
So they believe it was not helpful to try and be in the Manning offense.
Right.
And that this will be the year where they actually see...
Can evaluate him.
Uh-huh. Because the thing about the Kubiak offense is there's really no options. They're designed to, all right, take this, and if it's not there, look at your check down and or get rid of it.
Right.
And so it's a very simplistic offense, and so hopefully that will translate for Cody.
Because yeah.
I'm a fan of his. When he came out, I was like, that's going to be good.
Yeah, I mean, he's a tremendous athlete. There's no...
He dominated on special teams in the playoffs with K-1.
Yeah, that's true. Like that, I mean, you don't want to... You're not going to keep necessarily a high-profile receiver like that just for special teams, but him and Webster were big factors in the playoffs on special teams.
Mm-hmm. Oh, K-1 especially.
Yeah, if K-1 continues that way again, that'll be nice to watch. And that, I mean, that could be a case for the Broncos taking a chance on a punter like Riley Dixon if your coverage unit is as dominant as it was in the playoffs. That's a hard thing, I think, to say is going to be consistent, but I don't know.
And I think most of the possible cuts that are going to be made may go to them signing a major.
Oh my god.
What in the world? Am I playing with the Raiders?
Yeah. You're getting owned. You're gonna, is that Peppers? No, that's Porter.
No, it's Tracy Porter.
Tracy Porter.
Former not Bronco. Joey Porter.
How long was he on the roster? Was he there
I think
a full
just
season?
One, no, so it was a full season, his first year, and then didn't he get a concussion in like the first game of the second year?
I don't know. I don't even know what play I'm
running. I knew he had that interception against Pittsburgh in Manning's first game.
Right.
Come on, Broby.
Now the quarterback can't get him over.
But yeah, I think he got hurt the next year. I don't know. Obviously, he wasn't that memorable.
Yeah. No, I think the other thing to watch is the defensive line.
I want to see Gotsis, man.
Gotsis is coming along quicker than I think people thought. Because he was injured, right? That's what their concern with him was?
Yeah, he didn't do any OTA workouts or anything. Right. He was just rehabbing there.
Is he going to play this game?
He's been in, like, full pads. And actually, Von Miller told him that he looked like a beast.
Shit. Get that ball.
Bullshit!
Go, DeMarcus. We got ourselves a game.
Uh-oh.
Look at Brandon Marshall celebrating. Can I lateral? How do I lateral?
We can say that DeMarcus Ware won't be playing on Thursday.
Nor will Von Miller.
But this is encouraging, Ryan. Von Miller, or DeMarcus Ware, still dealing with back issues. They're bringing him slowly.
I don't know if they... It'll be great to have him as the third down rushers they're going to use him for. But Shane Ray has looked so good in camp.
When he's not getting yelled at by the coaches. Like, but I think they expect a lot of him. Like, I think that's what that's about.
He looks good. He looks built. He gained 10 pounds of muscle while also decreasing his body fat.
Which, if you work out, you know, is not easy.
I've worked out for two years,
Ryan, and have maybe put on half a pound of muscle. I take the protein. I do heavier weight hard sometimes, and it does not stack up. I'm still just like, I'm built like my mother.
You should do. Well, you should just do more protein. Like
I think that my inside muscular and bone structure is that of a woman's.
I'll agree with that.
I think exterior, I'm a man. Inside, I'm a woman. Physically, emotionally, I'm still kind of a child.
Yeah.
So.
Well, we knew that.
I have a hard time navigating through the world. Is what I'm saying. Oh.
Hey.
No.
It's all down here for Brandon. Here we go. Darian Stewart
Boy,
with the interception.
What a late game comeback. The Broncos decided this is a preseason game, but we are not losing, and we are keeping the first-string defense in.
Yeah, well, the Bears haven't put any backups in. I'm already on my third quarterback.
Yeah, well, Cutler, I don't know how to do that, honestly.
I gotta
hit pause and then switch them, or
yeah,
what?
I'm not gonna let you.
That's too much work.
That's way too much work. Who cares about the Bears backups?
No shit.
No, I'm excited to watch the running backs, though.
Oh, yeah, that should be fun.
I don't know. In practice, it seems like they just run into the back of the linemen a lot. But there are plays where you can see they broke the run off.
Right.
And there was Devontae Booker has the nastiest plant foot and cut. There was a play the other day where he cut and it was into a hole, so they were coming at us. And it just reminded me of the NFL films watching Terrell Davis cut back through the hole. It just had that same similar view, and I hope that's it. But again, it will all depend on how the offensive line, you know, stacks up.
Yeah, they got to be good. A lot of people are assuming they're going to be better. I've stated I don't know. I got to be sold on that.
Yeah, I would truly just say I don't know.
I think the other thing is people were surprised that Ronnie Hillman was listed ahead of Capri Bibbs because Bibbs has had a better camp than Hillman.
Well, look at the paychecks. Of course Ronnie Hillman's ahead of it.
Right. But I think that'll be interesting to watch because if Bibbs outperforms Hillman, it's like, why do you keep Hillman on the roster?
There have been rumblings that this game may depend on Ronnie Hillman's future because they want to, or they, people I've talked to believe the Broncos want to cut him early so he can get with another team.
Right.
And so this could be a really, a true make or break game for Ronnie Hillman.
So that might be another reason they list him higher on the depth chart now. Is CJ Anderson just going to play like a series? Is that probably the plan?
Yeah, well,
are they going to try to get him more work?
I don't know, because Veterans Day off, I don't know if he's ever had a day off.
They've been working him,
and he's said he likes it that way. Um, he He attributed his slow start last year to talking to other running backs who said, yeah, you should really save yourself during the preseason and then get going.
And he had a foot injury.
He had a foot injury as well. But so CJ had said in some of the interviews after practice that he's just going to go full out and just be CJ. So we'll see. He's looked quick. CJ always kind of lumbered, you know, right. and when he, like, broke the offensive line, unless it was against the Patriots, it was like, all right, someone's going to catch him. but he looks, he just looks quicker. He's thinner. And, yeah, the only reason I think Ronnie Hillman may stay is because he's a change of pace back.
Right. You
know, Capri is very similar to CJ. Devontae Booker is definitely faster, but he's not a small back.
No, he's a good-sized back. I mean, Hillman, during the season, did have some big runs in games.
He was the leading rusher for the team,
yeah.
Which actually surprised me when I looked at it at the end of the year.
But I'm excited to watch Booker. It's one thing watching these guys at practice. It'll be nice to see how they do when people are trying to tackle them. When you're talking about him kind of looking like Terrell Davis, have you watched any of the Arizona Cardinals show? All or Nothing,
no,
or whatever.
That's on my list.
Their running back, David Johnson, the guy who they drafted last year
from the FCS.
The way he runs reminds me of Terrell Davis.
I can see that.
They have the vision. Uh-huh. It's like they're fast. They're like deceptively fast, but they're not the fastest guy. Watch him, and that guy will remind you of the way Terrell Davis ran.
Yeah, watch him for fantasy football too. I think he's gonna have a breakout year.
Yeah, I haven't paid attention to what their running back depth chart is now, but I would imagine...
Well, Chris Johnson is gone.
Oh, is he?
Yeah, it's all... I think they want David Johnson to take it.
You can't have two Johnsons in the backfield. Trust me. Or the bedroom.
It gets painful.
Yep.
That's...
I've
been on the internet.
Of course, you know, you got... We haven't talked about him yet, but Tim Tebow in the news again.
I was hoping you didn't.
Tebow will not go away, Ryan. He thinks he can play professional baseball now.
Well,
which
he finally found a sport where grounders are acceptable.
Right, where he can throw it in the dirt and it's okay.
Yeah, where hitting fans in the third row may be a great thing. That, you know, that means he's actually scoring points.
I don't know.
I think he's trying to be an outfielder. Yeah. He wasn't terrible with, like, long throws. But it's just laughable. I don't know why. And this was just, like, all of a sudden he was...
Yeah, it's like, I'm gonna do baseball now.
Yeah.
I've been hanging out at the batting cages for a while, and I think I can fucking do this.
He wasn't a terrible high school baseball player. Oh, yeah.
In the flat.
God damn it.
Flag.
I think that's on Vaughn. I think I killed Jay Cutler.
You know, Tim Tebow, I'm going to make an episode about him, but he's kind of like Happy Gilmore right now.
Like, that'll be the first episode of yours I don't watch.
You know, he thought he was a football player, but just maybe he might be good at a different sport. They should document the whole thing. Follow him. They should document this process.
Oh,
he's
I'm sure
he's
is.
Gonna, he's gonna fail. Oh, it was on me.
It was on you, dude.
God damn it.
I guess it was holding.
Oh.
Oh, fuck. I looked down at my phone.
God, Davis.
I got a text message and I didn't see what happened. God damn it.
You called a fake punt.
I gotta pay attention.
That was bold. All right, I'm just gonna end the game here.
There's 3 minutes left. That's
all
impossible.
Right. All right.
I'm going to get you with your bathing.
You say that. No, you're not.
Ooh.
There it is.
Oh, well, Sanders is money.
I gave you one half to feel good about yourself.
Oh, there he is.
Why is he on the 5-yard line? He scored.
First and 10.
He definitely was in the end zone. Oh, man. Never change.
God damn it.
Are you really making a video about Tim Tebow?
I will. All
right.
It'll be about NFL news, Ryan.
Okay.
And that's going to be in there.
Okay.
I think the best part about it was, like, professional baseball players being offended, thinking that he can just walk in and play.
It's probably the same way those handball players got offended when the NBA players were like, yeah, you give us like 2 weeks to train, we could probably be pretty good handball players. Oh, no, not the Jake Plummer handball, the Olympic handball.
Right, because he did win the championship.
Jake Plummer's the boss. We got to get him on one of these podcasts.
He'll come.
He can bring his medical marijuana.
It's CBDs.
CBD?
Yeah, it doesn't get you cannabinoid. High, Ryan.
All right, well, then he can stay home.
Ryan wants to get fucking high with Jake Plummer.
Oh, that would be... I mean, come on. What Broncos fan doesn't want to get high with Jake Plummer?
All of them.
Yeah.
Except me. I would rather drink. I don't do good in social situations if I do drugs.
Wow. I thought you were just going to stop. I don't do good in social situations.
Well, there's probably some truth in both areas.
Mm-hmm.
I need to drink first, and then I can have a little.
What's your drink of choice? Like what?
Right now, I've just been drinking light beer all the time. Give me cheap Miller Lite. Oh,
you got Miller Lite right there on that sack.
But that's because it's the summer. It's the summer, Ryan. Like, it's hot. I want something cold.
I get it. Hey, as long as it's not Bud Light Lime.
I drink either beer or whiskey and wine. Beer, whiskey, and wine.
Eh.
But wine's been making my head hurt so bad lately that I've been avoiding it. I had like two and a half glasses.
You're such a desperate housewife.
I had two and a half glasses the other night, and I woke up and like I drank a bottle. I said, "What the fuck?" I didn't even like. It wasn't even enough to feel good the night before. Oh my god!
How have you not killed Jay Cutler in this game?
I'm trying. Do you think Jay Cutler will make it through the full season?
Has he ever?
I don't know. He takes a lot of shots.
I'll give him respect. He made it through an entire season with diabetes.
That is true. So, before they diagnosed what was wrong.
Yeah, so I'll back off on him there.
That's probably his best accomplishment as a quarterback.
Yeah, that's why I was kind of when he was in the NFC Championship and got hurt and people were calling him a pussy. I'm like, do you realize what he's gone through?
I think he's going to be shittier this year without Adam Gase there.
I think so too.
I mean,
who's their? I don't even know their new offensive coordinator.
I don't either. His name is Joe something.
Jojo.
Darren.
Joe
Johnny.
Darren.
Somebody will tell us.
JD.
JD McNugent.
All right.
You know what movie that's from?
JD McNugent.
JD
is
McNugent.
That's not Varsity Blues, is it?
No.
JD McNugent.
It's not a sports movie.
It's not a sports, and I don't know. If it's Mean Girls, I'm going to quit the game.
It's Saving Silverman.
Oh yeah!
Okay, Jack Black,
absolutely. JD McNugent.
JD McNugent.
I love that. I'm gonna have to watch that movie now. It's been so long since I've seen it.
I don't know if it holds up. I fucking loved that movie when I was like 13.
Oh, that's so true. I watched Space Jam a few years ago, and it is fucking terrible.
Like, ooh,
I don't know how I made it
that's
through.
That's not Forte. What am I living?
That's Langford, bro.
Yeah, I forgot. Who's Forte playing for? The Jets?
The Jets, yeah.
Yeah. That'll be interesting. If he can stay healthy, I still think he'll be effective.
I'm actually really excited to watch the AFC East. I think the Jets are going to be pretty good. I think the Bills are going to give the Patriots a run for the title.
Oh, I wish I had that sort of faith in Rex Ryan. I like Rex Ryan, but I don't know. Maybe that defense, especially since his brother's there.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know.
Well,
if that's,
okay, that's
I don't know if that's good.
Dude, no one has gotten further in this league based on his name than Rob Ryan.
Yeah. He's had like, what, one or two maybe decent years as a coordinator, but
he coached in historically bad Saints defense.
Right.
Historically terrible. Chris Harris finally waking up.
Yeah, I don't know how that guy has a job. Except for the fact that his brother hired him.
True.
But I don't think he's good.
I'm with you.
It sucks if you have like if you have Drew Brees as your quarterback and your defense is the worst in the league. That's just like insulting to Drew Brees.
That's what Peyton Manning had to put up with for a while.
Yeah, but they were
the Colts.
They were never the worst.
Right.
They just were never great or really good. Man, it's so unfortunate that Peyton had to, you know, be injured and face the end of his career with, like, severe physical decline and have, for the first time, the best defense in the NFL.
Career, yeah.
could you imagine if, I mean, if it was just the season before.
Right.
Before he hurt his leg.
Well, and that's what just pisses me off so much about Jack Del Rio is because you were just watching, especially the Colts playoff game, when he had a keeve on T.Y. Hilton, when you should obviously have Chris Harris, when he's only rushing four players every down. It was just...
Yeah, Del Rio turned out to be a piece of shit. Like, him and Elway didn't get along, and he...
There was rumors that there was a huge fight between those two.
Yeah, I've heard that.
Like, almost physical blows. But a Raiders blog, I think, reported that, so I don't know if I trust it.
I've heard it. It's like one of those things that nobody's supposed to talk about, I guess.
I believe it.
But yeah, he refused to put players in the best situation, you know, possible. And that's like what the difference was when Wade Phillips came in.
Yeah.
He's like, oh yeah, this guy does this well.
Oh,
what the fuck?
That's it.
But it just sucks now that the Raiders are starting to get good.
Actually, I am going to take the unpopular opinion. I am happy the Raiders are probably going to be good now.
So that there's a rivalry again?
That there's a rivalry again. Did you know there are now children getting driver's license permits that have not seen a Raiders winning season? That's how terrible they've been.
No, I think the competition's good.
Yeah.
I just don't want him to get the credit for it. And maybe Jack Del Rio's a better head coach than he is. I mean... You know, he made a name for himself as a defensive coordinator.
A lot of people forget guy. He took the Jaguars to the playoffs.
Yeah, I think he's better, though, at letting somebody else run the defense and he manages the team.
Personnel-wise?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because who is the Raiders' defensive coordinator? I don't even know.
I feel like it's someone I should know.
But they've been... Their general managers made the biggest difference over there. I can't remember that guy's name now.
The dude with the haircut, Mark something.
The curly.
All right, DT. Let's get two hands on it.
It's just nice that there's actually a game happening.
Oh. Training camp has been so boring.
Yeah. Anybody who says it isn't is a liar.
Is a liar or has gone one day.
It's funny because like Ryan and I are there getting video and then we got to edit videos together and shit like that. We're not like actually part of the media covering it and talking about it every day.
That's going to be fun.
But what amazes me is how like guys who do radio professionally, how they make stories out of nothing happening at camp.
Yeah.
Like the first practice I watched, you could barely see anything. The team was practicing as far away from us as possible. And on my car ride home, I was listening and they were saying shit that I was like, that's not true. They didn't see that there. Like, this guy looked great today. I was like, yeah, he maybe had one, he had a good catch and no contact drills.
Right.
But that, I mean, that's why they have those jobs.
My, I guess, requirements for someone having a good day is they've caught my eye three or more times.
Right.
So
that makes
whether
sense.
It's like Lorenzo Doss batting down a pass, then he picked one off, you know, with Sanders, all that stuff. That's when it's like, all right, he's clearly making some type of impact.
Woo!
That was actually a very Paxton Lynch throw.
Yeah, Paxton Lynch has looked inaccurate at times. That's been his biggest struggle so far.
Andrew Mason put it best. Shout out to Andrew Mason, one of my favorites. He said, Paxton Lynch will have the best throw every practice, but he will also have the two worst throws. And it's so true.
That's funny.
Because you can see he's clearly the best physical quarterback on the roster. It's,
right.
Hands down.
He's
it's
got
not
the,
even close.
The tools.
He's
the
got
gift.
The tools. He's got the arm. He just has to... I think it's just game speed at this point. I think he's just not used to the way that the corners covered, the ways that the receivers cut and are, you know...
Yeah.
I mean, look at...
Because his bad throws are, I think, connected to him trying to grasp onto the game mentally, right?
Right.
It's not like Tim Tebow where he just can't fucking throw.
No. It's yeah, he's just anticipating... Get that. He's anticipating where the receiver is going to be.
Right.
And so... But at the end of practice, when they put him in 11-on-11, say, drive down and score, and he sits back there and slings it, he's on.
And so that's why I'm really excited for the preseason game, because I think once he's in the game, finally gets a little flow going, I think he's going to tear it up, especially against 13 defenses.
Yeah, it'll be fun to watch. I mean, Trevor Siemian looked awesome last preseason. So it'll be nice to see him play against some better competition.
Yeah,
to see. You know, against the twos or whatever.
Because jury's still out. I'll give you a timeout here so you can...
Yeah, Lynch is... You know, he's going to be a work in progress. I think everybody knew that going into training camp and after the draft. It's just strange not having that... not knowing the quarterback.
Uh-huh.
Like, we haven't had to deal with that for a while.
Yeah, when was the last time?
It was, you know, the season before Manning arrived. So it was...
And even then, I think
Tebow, people, Orton.
Yeah, but I think even at that point, like, if you're a coach watching practice film, Chris Harris icing it!
Ooh, this was a blowout.
I think if you were a coach watching practice film, I don't know who would say, oh yeah, Tim Tebow has obviously earned the starter. And that's why I think Kyle started that
right.
season.
No, I mean, that's what I'm saying. Like, yeah. That season was the last time there was uncertainty.
Okay, I see what you're saying there. But yeah, in terms of, like, a job that was truly up for grabs, I think you have to go back to Brister Greasy.
Yeah, and supposedly, you know, Shanahan said Brister was the starter during preseason. And then he changed his mind and apparently pissed off the entire team.
I kind of believe that.
I've heard him talk about it at camp, how that decision made a lot of guys angry.
And it wasn't the last time he did it when he
no,
sat
he did it with Cutler
at the. He was, gosh, we were 7.
The Cutler one was worse too.
I think so.
Like, listening to Jake talk about that season and
poor Jake.
Different guys, that sort of just killed any momentum or. It's hard when you got a guy like Plummer that the team respects and is going to back up.
Look at that arm. No,
awesome. Can you imagine, though, like, if Elway didn't retire, Terrell Davis probably wouldn't have blown his knee out?
Actually, I didn't know this, but a lot of people blame Brian Greasy for that injury.
Yeah, because he threw a pick.
He threw a pick, and Terrell Davis blew his knee out
trying to make a tackle.
Come on, it's football. If anything, blame Lepsis, who took TD out.
Well,
had to go low.
It's Greasy's fault.
Okay.
He's got a great career now as a broadcaster. It's okay to put the blame on him.
TD's not doing too bad either.
No. He was at the camp.
You think he gets a Hall of Fame next year?
That was a fucking shame that him or Atwater didn't get in.
Aeneas Williams gets in.
I hope TD does. I honestly thought Atwater had a chance.
And I love John Lynch, but I cannot. He gets in before Atwater.
Steve Atwater had more tackles than Kevin Greene.
Yeah.
And Kevin Greene was a linebacker defensive end.
Uh-huh.
And Kevin Greene got in. And Steve Atwater basically, he was one of those guys that stood out at his position and sort of transformed that position. So that surprised me. I guess other people weren't as surprised about him not getting in, but I would have liked to see it. Uh-oh, somebody's here.
Oh.
Well, the game's over.
Yeah, I guess we have to end the podcast.
Ryan and the Broncos win, which is a good thing for everybody.
25-14.
So we'll expect Thursday night a 25-14 Broncos victory over the Bears. You can also expect the starters to play the entire game.
Yeah, Jay Cutler is going to have a 44% completion rating. I said that one wrong.
44. Lynch was 42.
Lynch is going to have 51 yards passing.
Well... That was pretty good was for good. Our first podcast, Ryan. Playing video games and podcasting. We're going to try to do this all season. Hopefully every Wednesday or Thursday we'll have a new one.
Bring light beer next time.
We need to do this in the evening.
Yeah.
And then have beer. Well, thanks for watching That's Good Broncos.
Or listening.
And listening. On SoundCloud. If you're on YouTube right now, I'm going to put this on SoundCloud, so download it there. Make sure you follow Ryan on Twitter. What's your Twitter handle?
R Greene. Greene has an E at the end, and it's 5280.
5280. Ryan and I make tons of Broncos videos. We're both awesome. Follow us. Bye.
Bye.